Hi guys, welcome to our channel Beyond Stocks. So today we are going to review Motilal Oswal S&P 500 Index Fund, which is a US fund. In our previous videos, we have already reviewed Motilal Oswal NASDAQ 100. So if you want to know more about that fund, you can just find the link below in the description box. We are going to tell about this fund, which has been recently launched in the year 2020 itself. And let us see what we have inside. Also, if you like our content about this mutual fund, do not forget to subscribe and share it with your friends and family. So let us know more about Motilal Oswal S&P 500 Index Fund. So first of all, this particular fund invests in S&P 500 Index, which is the world's largest index, which we see here. Apart from that, as I earlier mentioned, this is one of the recent fund which we have come across for all of us. That is, it has been launched in 28th April 2020 itself. So talking about the expense ratio, so every mutual fund has two types of ratio. That is, one is the direct investing and one is the regular investing, which we see. In the direct investing, if you invest 500 rupees in the fund, you have to pay 0.49% as an expense ratio. And if you invest it in the regular method, it's 1.19%, that is including GST, as an expense ratio. So we would recommend that you can just invest in this mutual fund directly, as the expense ratio is quite less as compared to the regular one. Apart from that, if we see the exit load, so if you redeem the fund before 3 months, you have to pay 1% as the exit load. So it's always advisable to invest in a mutual fund for a longer period of time. Either go for 1 year or more. 1 year is again shorter, but you can go for 5 years, 10 years, but not less than 3 months. Since now we are aware that Motilal Oswal Fund directly invests in S&P 500 index, so we would be covering more facts and returns and other related aspects with related to S&P 500 index. So one of the interesting facts which we came across is S&P 500 index invests in the leading 500 companies in US. Apart from this, recently Tesla was added in the S&P 500 index very recently, which is a very positive thing for the company. Also, S&P 500 index and the economy goes hand in hand. Like, people actually gauge the economy, how is it performing, on the basis of S&P 500 index, because this contains the top 500 companies. If they are performing good, then automatically the S&P 500 index will perform good, and vice versa. So it's almost related, interrelated to each other. Another interesting fact is top four passive funds by AUM worldwide tracks S&P 500 because they benchmark their own performance with S&P 500. Because a lot of people are investing in this particular fund, and it has also been recommended by Warren Buffett and John Bogle, which are famous investors who recommend this particular fund to everyone.
So let me add more facts about S&P 500 index. So Nidhi has already covered some of the facts. So let me again cover more of this. So it is one of the oldest kind of index that is almost like 63 years old now. So it is one of the very oldest index in the world. Apart from this, it's one of the most popular and tracked index in the world. As Nidhi told, like four top mutual funds by AUM in the world track this S&P 500 index. And it has like pure large cap exposure. As we will see later, like a lot of large caps are a part of this S&P 500 index. And other than this, like this is one important point, 40% of the sales of S&P 500 companies comes from outside US. Like if you take example of Amazon or Google, like many of their revenues also comes from outside of US, from India and many other countries, from European countries and many other countries. And also if you are investing in this fund, like Motilal Oswal S&P 500 index, of course you will be investing in rupees. And if the US dollar keeps on strengthening and rupee keeps on weakening, then also you benefit from this movement in the conversion ratio between the dollar and the rupee. And other than that, this index fund has very low correlation with the Indian equity market, because both the India and US are different. I mean, if something happens in India, like something bad happens in India, it's not that the US market will also get affected by that. Other way it may be true, but not this way. I mean, if something happens bad in the US market, it may happen that Indian market will also get affected. But the reverse is not always true. Let's now look at the companies which are a part of S&P 500 index. You'll be surprised to see like many of these companies are the brands that you use in your day-to-day life. Take example of Amazon, Apple, Microsoft, Facebook, Google, and many others are there. You can see example of Adobe is there, Starbucks is there, MACD is there, IBM is there. Like you can see, like it, like this index consists of a lot of large cap companies in US, and these are like some of the biggest companies even in the world, not even in US, even in the world. These are some of the biggest companies there. So you are basically investing in these biggest companies of the world here if you're investing in S&P 500 index. And also, as Nidhi mentioned before, that Tesla also had joined the S&P 500 index. It's not there in this list here because this PPT is slightly old, but you will also find Tesla in the S&P 500 index now. So let's now look at the stocks weightage in this index and also the sector weightage in this index. So if you look at the stocks weightage, so Microsoft has around 5.89% in this S&P 500 index. Apple has 5.77. Amazon has 4.39. Like these are the major ones. Others also have around 2 or 1%. For example, Facebook has around 2%. Visa has around 1.26%. So others have less than this. So top three, if you see, are close to 15% of this index. So Microsoft, Apple, and Amazon. So if you see in terms of sector index weighted percent, like 27% of the allocation is done to the information technology companies. For example, you have seen Microsoft, Apple, Amazon. Then healthcare is close to 14.4%. Communication devices, 10.7. Consumer dictionary, 10.7. Financial, 10. And others are less. So of course, if you see the top three, it's IT, healthcare, and communication services, which are also dominating the whole world. I mean, they are growing very fastly in this current world. And keep track of these numbers, like what I have shown you here, because we'll be comparing this with the NASDAQ 100 fund, where the numbers are quite different, you will see. So let's now see the, so just see the numbers, like here you see IT weightage is 27%. And also if you see the stocks weightage is close to like 5% or less than 5%. So let's now look at the NASDAQ 100 sector-wise weightage. So if you see Motilal Oswal NASDAQ 100 ETF composition, you see the difference here. Here the difference is that Apple has 12.5% here, Microsoft has 10%, Amazon has 10%. So you see the numbers, it's almost double from the S&P 500 index. Now, if you see in terms of sector or industry weightage, 32% is allocated to software and services and 15% to technology, hardware and equipment. So both of these are kind of tech itself, technology itself. And if you see the weightage of technology is close to 50%, if you sum the software and the technology, hardware, equipment. But if you see in the S&P 500 index fund, it was less than this, like it was 27% close to. So of course you can see the weightage in the stocks also, like Apple's weightage is quite higher here. Microsoft weightage is quite higher here. Amazon also, almost they are double of this. So this is very important to note the difference between both of these funds.
As we've seen the facts of this fund, now let us see the lump sum returns over the period of time for this particular fund. Here we have compared S&P 500 index fund with Nifty 500 and Nifty 50 index fund. So here, as we would be investing in rupees, we have showcased this particular thing in INR, that is in rupees. So if we see the 5-year returns for S&P 500, it's 14.2%. And for Nifty 500, it's 5.5%. Also, if you see the longer period of term, that is 10-year and 15-year, S&P 500 gives 19.4% and Nifty 500 gives 8%. If we see the 15-year plan, here CAGR for S&P 500, it's 12.8 and for Nifty 500, it's 11.8. There's not much difference here, but again, year two, S&P 500 has beaten Nifty 500, which is a very positive thing for this particular fund, because it has directly invested in S&P 500 index. As we saw the lump sum returns, now let us see the SIP returns of this particular fund, because most of us would be definitely going for the SIP thing because it's a monthly investing procedure. Here I have compared S&P 500 with Nifty 500. So if we see 5-year returns for SIP, if you have invested 10,000 rupees every month in the previous 5 years, you would have gotten a return of 14.99% versus if you've invested again the same 10,000 rupees every month in Nifty 500, you would have gotten 2.85% return. So we see a huge difference here. Also, if we see the 10-year SIP, so if you have the same 10,000 rupees, if you've invested it every month in the 10-year, you would have received 17.12% return in S&P 500 and 7.91 return in Nifty 500. So again, there's a huge difference between both the funds. So we see that S&P 500 has beaten Nifty 500 in SIP returns as well.
Also, it is very important to note that the data we have shown you here is of close to June 2020. which is slightly old data, and we know that the markets has ran a lot higher after June. I mean, like all the markets are at all time high now, even the India market or US market. So the actual returns will be a bit higher than that, what we have shown you there. Other than that, Motilal Oswal AMC, which actually runs the NASDAQ 100 ETF and also the S&P 500 index fund, which you are talking there, it has also given an advisory to all the investors of these funds that do not expect the returns of the past. For example, if you see in S&P, the returns has been like 20% or more than 20% in the last 10 years. I mean, if you see I'm also taking the returns of the after the June also, it will be higher than 20% close to. So do not expect those returns. And if you see NASDAQ 100, it may be around 25-30% in that fund. So do not expect this much returns going into the future. What you should expect is close to, I will say, maybe 12-15% returns. That's what most index funds give, Simon, if you see in the long term. And since US companies consist of tech companies, which are growing very fast, you may get around 12-15% return. And also do remember that the US market has been in bull run for last 10 years almost. Like that's why you are seeing this much return, Simon. Like if you go to 15 years return, it was close to 12% as we have seen there. So of course, expect around 12-15% returns. And another important point to note is that in the last like 5 years, 10 years, if you see, rupee has been weakening and dollar has been like strengthening, I mean. That's why you see the difference here in returns. Like if you see in the USD terms, in the dollar terms, S&P 500 has given close to only 3.6 times returns in last close to 15 years. But if you see the S&P 500 in terms of INR, you see the difference. It's almost 6 times returns. So you see the huge difference here. The huge difference is because of the conversion rate, because rupee has been weakening. I mean, it's close to 73 now. Earlier it used to be like 50. Then before that it used to be like 40. So this also you should note, because in future, if the rupee gets stronger, the returns will again decrease here. And if the rupee keeps on weakening in the future also, your returns may be higher here. Now let's talk about difference between S&P 500 index and NASDAQ 100, because Motilal Oswal has two separate funds for both of these. So you will be of course answering, like you will be asking a question like whether I should invest in S&P 500 or should I invest in NASDAQ 100. So you see the difference here, like S&P invest in broader market, like it invests in a lot of companies, whether they are in IT or whether they are in healthcare, like lot of sectors are covered here. NASDAQ 100 is different. It is technology heavy company with a lot of money of NASDAQ 100 getting invested into companies like Amazon, Apple, Microsoft and others. Also, if you see number of companies, also difference is huge here. Like S&P 500 tracks 500 companies. NASDAQ tracks only 100 companies. So if you see in terms of market cap, S&P covers 85% market cap of US listed companies. But NASDAQ only covers only 35% of the market cap. Also sectors, if you see like S&P covers 11 sectors, whereas NASDAQ only covers 7 sectors. And last but very important thing is the sector weightage, if you see. IT information technology weighting in NASDAQ is 48%, like close to 50%. In S&P, it's very less, not very less, but it's 27%, which is lesser than NASDAQ 100. So if you are like, if you want to invest in like if you want to invest in tech funds, like tech fund in the sense that if you want to invest heavily into likes of Amazon, Apple, Google, go with NASDAQ 100. But if you want to invest in the broader US market, like all the other companies also, like we have seen some examples of other companies like Starbucks or many others were there in that, Procter & Gamble, many FMCG companies were there in S&P 500. So if you want to invest in a broader market of US, go for S&P 500. But if you want to mostly invest into tech companies which are growing fast, invest into NASDAQ 100. Or you also have the option of investing into both if you want to. Like you can start SIP in both also.
So this was all about Motilal Oswal and S&P 500 index fund, all the information which was required. So if you have any other fund in your mind, do let us know. We could, read about that and make a video on that as well. Also, if you like our content, do not forget to share it with your friends and family and do subscribe and like the channel. Thanks.